Archbishop of Church of Uganda, His Grace Stanley Tagale, has today publicly apologized to the nation, but also to the church, for committing adultery. This was during prayers at St. Paul Cathedral, Namirembe, to celebrate the church's 60 years of independence.
Prayers to celebrate 60 years of Church of Uganda's independence was attended by different bishops, former Prime Minister Amama Mbabazi, and Government Chief Whip Ruth Nankabirwa, among others. The prayers were led by the Archbishop Church of Uganda, Dr. Samuel Stephen Kazimba Mugalo. Afterwards, Archbishop Kazimba thanked all those who have supported the church for the last 60 years. He later invited his predecessor, Right Reverend Stanley Ntagali, to address the congregation. During his address, Ntagali publicly apologized for the extramarital affair.
Praise the Lord. Your Grace, thank you for inviting me to join in this wonderful celebration of our 60th year of celebration as a self-governed church. In the spirit of the East African revival, of which I'm a product, I have a confession. On Christmas Eve 1974, as a young man, I gave my life to the Lord Jesus Christ. And I still have the Lord because He has loved me, and I have loved to serve Him over the years. Sadly, I fell into sin of adultery, and I confess to the Lord to forgive me, and I want the church to forgive me, my brother bishops, all our partners, brothers and sisters in the vineyard of the Lord, the entire Church of Uganda, and all our partners all over the world, and the family of Reverend Christopher and his wife Judith. Two families, please forgive me. And I want to remain closer to Jesus, and I want to hide my life on the unshakable rock. I want to continue on that solid rock. So my life is focused on eternity, because the worldly things will end. One day I will stand before the Lord to give accountability of what I did in this world. And that is more important for me than anything else. So I thank the Lord for loving me, and I continue serving Him until He calls me home. Praise the Lord.
Former Prime Minister Amama Mbabazi was the chief guest at the event and thanked all those who were able to develop the church to the current level.
I was impressed by the recent Archbishop's leadership summit that was held virtually, attracting hundreds of Church of Uganda leaders. We must embrace technology and enhance digital communications as we serve our people entrusted in our care by our Lord. To contemplate the story of Church of Uganda is, in a sense, to be reminded of the itself.
Mbabazi appreciated the responsibility given to him to be the chairperson of the 60th anniversary of the Ugandan Church and promised to take it forward. Jesus, He is the same.